What's going on, guys? It's your boy Death here, and today we're going to be playing some more Fallout 4. Now, hold up, I gotta plug my controller into the charger because it is gonna die. So, there we go. Now, I hope that you guys have enjoyed the series. It's probably coming close to an end, and it's been going on for almost a year now, so let's talk to Desdemona.
Status report.
We got activity, Des. Not sure how long before it peaks.
The Institute is a huge unknown. Before we can make any plans, we need to do something. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot.
I like the name. Sounds encouraging.
There's a man, or woman, we're not sure, inside the Institute who helps synths escape to freedom. Dozens of synths owe him their lives. We don't know his name. We've never had a way to contact him. So we gave him the code name, Patriot. If your plan works, and you're able to get inside the Institute, we need you to make contact.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Tom's encrypted a message for Patriot's eyes only. Once he sees it, he'll contact you. Until you make contact, and probably after, you need to stay in their good graces. You need to infiltrate them. Can you do that? Can you be our agent on the inside?
Bring it on.
You can do this. I believe in you. Stand on the platform and I'll give you the holotape. Just plug it into any Institute terminal and wait for the reply. Tom, talk to me.
Bring up the scan sequence. This frequency
okay.
Is only going to work once. You know who doesn't make the same mistake twice.
Hey, go ahead. Go ahead.
Your thoughts?
Do me a favor. Once you're in there, remember the looks on the faces of those Institute goons.
Your thoughts?
I've been told the Valentine Detective Agency signs are an eyesore. But they sure bring in the business.
Oh, nothing.
Well, all right.
Okay, let me check my current quest, because I need to get that thing for Virgil. Alright, guess this is it. Alright. Of course.
Here's the latest word on what's happening in the Commonwealth, folks. Not content with...
My cat came inside at that time. Can't move.
So stand still. You gotta lock in all those molecules of yours. Hopefully we won't miss any. There's only, you know, 60 trillion of them. All right, feeding our baby some juice. Let's see what she's got.
Take this holotape. You need it to contact Patriot.
Oh, man, don't worry. That's all part of the plan.
Tom, do whatever you can to gain their trust. Lie. Tell them what they want to hear. Make up a cover story and sell it.
Come on, I think I got it. Establishing lock on the Institute signal.
Just get all the information you can. About synths. About the Institute's plans. Find their weaknesses. If we can disable or destroy the Institute, we may have to do it. You jack that holotape into any terminal, and Patriot will make contact. He has to.
Got the aura! We got it!
Find a way to save them. Nobody else can.
Now!
Huh. Here we are. I just gotta... At the Institute.
I am known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here. I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Please. Step into the elevator.
I'm gonna make a save.
I can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean? Oh my God. It's really you.
Who are you?
Sean, where is everyone?
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Sean, are you okay? You're not hurt, are you?
What's going on? Father? Father!
Shh, shh, it'll be okay, Sean. I'm here now.
I don't know you. Go away. Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Who is Father? Where is he?
Father? Father, help me! He's trying to take me! Father? Father, help me!
Sean. S-923, recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Give me Sean, the real Sean, right now!
I know. I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him.
I'll make this very simple. Where is my son?
He's here, in the Institute. Closer than you think. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been rewarded. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean. I am your son.
It's really you? After all this time?
Yes. It's true. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the sun you'd lost. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant, but a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? That is the reality. And here I am, raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
It wasn't right, what they did. Taking you from me like that.
To you, that would certainly seem true. But to the Institute, it made all the sense in the world. At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production. But it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being, walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. But then the Institute found me, after discovering records from Vault 111. An infant, frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
Sean, it's really you.
It really is. I know you must have questions. Please, anything I can do to help you understand.
Kellogg, he worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
You knew the man was a psychopath, but you used him anyway?
Would you have preferred that I turned him loose on the Commonwealth? At least keeping him on a short leash kept the collateral damage to a minimum. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute, but his cruelty became more apparent with every completed objective. I won't lie. It's no coincidence your path crossed his. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Your mother. She never got to see you grow up.
Yes. What happened to her was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
Collateral damage? Is that all she was to you?
I forget that it's been such a short time for you. I don't have any direct memories. And I've had my entire life to cope with a loss. Has it always been easy? Of course not. But I've done my best to move on and live my life. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that. With old age comes regret, and asking what if more often. But what matters now is that you and I have a chance to begin again. What else can I say? To ease your mind.
So you're in charge of the Institute?
I am the acting director, yes. I spent decades working to reach this point. It's a responsibility I take very seriously. The Institute. It's important. It really is humanity's best hope for the future, no matter what those above ground might think of us.
But, director? Why you?
I was the most qualified for the position. Obviously. I've lived my life within these walls. Dedicated to science like every other member of the Institute. My hard work has paid off. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Whatever you've seen or heard, I know I can convince you of that. Just give me time. I know there's more for us to discuss, but the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs. Your presence would be appreciated as we approach them. I've been a part of something amazing here. I've helped to build a life for myself and the people of the Institute. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Maybe. I don't know. This is so much to take in.
I know. And I am sorry. You have been through so much in such a short time. The Institute can provide a better life than anything above ground. You've been in the Commonwealth. You've seen what it's like. I assure you that you are better off with us.
Things are pretty terrible up there.
I've seen it myself. I know. That is why we are so committed to creating a better life for ourselves here. And it's a life that you can now be part of. I simply ask that you give the Institute, me, a chance. A chance to show you what I've been telling you. We really do have humanity's best interest at heart. Will you take that chance?
All right.
Thank you. The Institute is now your home as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in facilities, Dr. Ale in SRB, Dr. Holdren in bioscience, and finally Dr. Lee in advanced systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next.
Well, damn. All right, guys. I am back.
Almost done. Just need to tighten up this primary drive servo.
They weren't kidding. You really are here. Well, all right. I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore. You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
I just wanted to find my son. Keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
Absolutely.
Oh, good to hear. It'll be a load off Sean's mind. Take your time. Get yourself acquainted. There's a lot to take in. Plenty of things you won't find topside. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Goodbye, then. That's the third primary drive breakdown this month. As far as I'm concerned, the phase out on these older models can't come soon enough.
Oh, I don't know. Most of them have lasted long past the projected lifespan.
Thank you. all, sir. Authorized personnel only.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, does he? Well, you can tell him that I intend to speak to Father about these unannounced security sweeps of yours. Ransacking my quarters in the middle of the night is totally unacceptable.
I'll pass along your message, Doctor.
See that you do. When the lights go down and the stars come out, man just forgets about all his troubles.
Well, nothing to report, sir.
Hey.
Scanning. Subject identified.
I'm seriously thinking of heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
They're dragging their feet on the targeting package upgrades I asked for. Maybe I should take some courses with me.
You're here. Glad
Please
you made
don't.
It.
There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
You going soft on me, Alana? My methods get results, and they will this time as well. You'll see. If
you
see any suspicious synth activity,
you, but try to remember
report it
that
immediately.
Synths aren't people.
Hey, Doc.
So, here you are. Justin Ayo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Why? Don't you trust me?
I'll be honest. You're an outsider. The first outsider to be allowed access to the Institute in quite a long time, in fact. There's little precedent for this situation, so it's only natural to take extra precautions. It's nothing personal, I assure you. Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
If the synths want to be free, you should let them.
Synths do not want. They might look like human beings, but they're machines. As to why they're escaping? That matter is currently under investigation. Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our Coursers are relentless. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I'm no stranger to combat.
Even so, a courser should be more than a match for any single combatant. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Very well.
This is kind of awkward
Scanning
because I don't know.
Identity. Clearance confirmed.
I don't know if I want to work with the railroad or the Institute. If you guys can, please let me know if, like, I really want to get the trophies for Underground Undercover
it's
and stuff
an honor
like that.
To have you here, sir.
Hi.
I wouldn't be here if not for your son.
When are you going to tell me about this mysterious Phase 3?
You know I can't talk about that.
Please don't get any germs on me.
We're all looking forward to working with you. She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for
Excuse me, doctor?
Ah, it's you.
You're here then. Yes, yes, I know who you are. We all do. While I'm sure Father is very happy that you're here, I do hope it doesn't interrupt our work.
Don't worry.
I promise I won't get in your way.
Thank you. I do appreciate that. Oh, before I forget, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a Courser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement. In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Now, unless there's something else, I really do need to get back to work.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
All right.
We are honored to welcome you. Examine my latest reports on Batch 274.
Not yet. I've been reviewing Father's plans to expand our operations at Warwick.
Hi, Doc.
I wonder how the
Welcome.
Warwick family is
so
doing.
Good to have you here.
Young
Dr. Wally Clayton Holden,
10 years old by
head
now.
Of the Bioscience
Division.
Remarkable. I can't wait for you to see the work
so
we're doing.
Up there, don't you
it's
think?
Truly amazing.
I look forward to learning more about it.
In that case, let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Seems like there's nothing you guys can't do.
With hard work and ingenuity, any challenge can be overcome. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is. But I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
Oh, fucking chores. Fucking course, I mean. Chores. What the fuck is wrong with me? I have, like, dyslexia or some shit. Shut up, Austin.
I'm not sure how well I'll fit in, but I'd like to give it a try.
Great. I was hoping you'd say that. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Take care, then.
Why is that with the... Alright, well, hopefully you guys enjoyed. My name is Death, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.